You can use an Oracle Cloud Stack template to provision an integration cloud instance automatically. A stack template describes a set of services that'll be provisioned together. In this case, that includes not just Integration Cloud itself, but Oracle Database Cloud Service and an Oracle Storage Cloud Service container, both of which are used by the Integration Cloud instance. Using a stack template with Integration Cloud offers a choice of three feature sets: integration, integration and process, or integration, process, and integration analytics. The integration analytics option will cause two Integration Cloud instances to be installed with specific containers, but sharing the database. To use a template, you'll first need to note a reference to your storage account. To find that reference, click the menu icon on the Storage Classic tile of your My Services page. Select the View Details option. When the details are displayed, copy the value of the account reference and save it for later. Then, return to your dashboard. On the Integration Cloud tile, open the menu and select Open Service Console. From the menu in the upper left corner of the screen, select Oracle Cloud Stack, and then navigate to the Templates tab. Select the template by filtering on the name. In this case, I type in the word integration, and the Integration Cloud template is displayed. To view a graphical representation of the components in a template, click the template icon or the template name. The Topology tab shows the graphical representation of what will be created by the stack template. The Template tab shows the contents of the template file in YAML format. To create a stack, click the Create icon at the far right of the template you want to use. Enter a stack name. Instance names will have this stack name prepended to them, so it's best to keep it short. You can optionally enter a description. The Template field displays the template that will be used to create the stack. Enter an email address where you'd like to receive notifications of instance provisioning progress, for example, when provisioning completes. Selecting the On Failure Retain Resources option would preserve both successful and failed services in case of a partial provisioning failure. You won't normally select this option, but it may be of use if you're ever working with Oracle support to debug a provisioning problem. To automatically create a Storage Cloud Service container instance for backup and recovery, enter the storage container reference you saved earlier. Provide your storage container username and password. This is the user login you use when you log into the My Services console. In the Service section, provide an SSH public key. You can either upload an existing key, supply a key value, or create a new key pair. To create a new pair, select Create a New Key and click Enter. After it's been created, download the key pair to your local machine. It'll enable you to access your virtual machines if you're ever doing any troubleshooting with Oracle's guidance. Next, select the feature set you want to provision. You can select Integration Features, Integration and Process Features, or Integration and Process plus Integration Analytics Features. Visual Builder is installed automatically with each feature set. Finally, enter the number of nodes you want to start with. You can scale in or scale out later in the Integration Cloud My Services console. Next, review the values that you provided. Confirm these values to trigger the provisioning process. Provisioning is underway. From here, you can refresh the screen to view the latest status, or select the Activity tab to view log messages showing the provisioning status. When provisioning is done, your instance is ready to use. For more information, visit us online.